Still on the environment, the Environmental Protection Agency, EPA, wants clearance from government to recruit more officers. The agency says low staff strength continues to limit its performance. Just about 350 officers serve the entire country, a situation PRO of the EPA, Angelina Mensah, considers worrying. A presidential fiat, according to her, will remove frustrations and bottlenecks the agency faces, especially going through the Public Services Commission to recruit staff. She was speaking to JoyNews' Adelaide Arthur.
Taking care of pesticides and chemicals, we are taking care of human settlement, we are doing climate change, we are doing mining, we are doing oil and gas, we are so environmental assessment. So how many people do you think should be in each department? And sometimes I ask myself, can't we have a presidential fiat for us to at least employ about 100 people? Because if we do compliance, monitoring and compliance, and we move people from head office and go to the regions, because of the numbers, they could actually shut down recalcitrant companies or industries. There are others who even don't have permit, and then when they go on the field, they see it. But if you're only two in a region, or three in a region, one is an administrator, okay, four, the driver, the administrator, the regional director, and the assistant, what can you do? We need a presidential fiat to hire and engage people to work with, because we would be paying them with internally generated fund. We've been asked to pay ourselves now. And we do not want the process where they will say, go through the Public Services Commission, because they put a lot of impediment in our ways. The presidential fiat supersedes the Public Services Commission's requirement. So we need that, and it's very, very urgent. It should be looked at critically, because if the environment is not healthy, your people are also sick, your economy would also fall into status. This is basically what it is.
You're watching JoyNews Desk with me, Bernice Abubedu. We'll take a quick breather now. When we come back, we'll be discussing Ghana's worst corruption perception in the score since 2012 and more. Do stay.